beat down on bone and backs. The ocean.
There's a, the Australian servers sort of running at the moment. We are kind of owning it. Yeah. Anyone? Oh, well, I've got a i7-5820 with a 16 gig of RAM. What else have I got? 970 GTX, so I could... Yeah, it's a good card. I could get a better one, you know. But I'm happy with it. I don't know what my FPS is. It depends on the server, man. Like, so if you're on an American server and it's full, my frame rate's like bottom out. I was playing this morning. Yeah, and everyone was teleporting around. Like, a lot of it's the netcode. You know, like, a lot of it's because the game's unoptimized. I get blue screens from time to time. And, I should be running this on my SSD, but I'm not. Oh, don't you dare. What are you running? But what do you have?
Control point contested.
Don't let them take the control point.
All I am is the bones you
know the
made
model?
For me. So garishly clean. White as the horse.
Oh, yeah. Yes, I
am.
Yeah, look man, that's like the trick will be, especially with those specs, is to play the lower pop games on the local server. You'll get, like I'm playing now and it's, I don't know what solid 60 looks like, but it's what I imagine you know, like I'm not getting much frame lag. Yeah, but when if even for me with my rig, and I know a lot of people who've been running 1080s and stuff, full server, like it just slows to a crawl. People start teleporting everywhere. Part of it is the client's not optimized, like what you're playing. But part of it is the server's not optimized as well. So the application runs on the server end. Sorry. It depends on the model of your CPU. But I've got a 7970 in my other rig, because I've got a 3930 as well. It seems to, like, doesn't seem to be a lot in it for performance. And 7970 is quite an older card now. But my suspicion is that a lot of it's just in the program itself. Like, you could probably do with a better card, man, but depending on the i7... Shit. Little bastard. Oh, yes, sorry. So, you can find out what model your CPU is just by running DXDiag into, like, if you go to a little window search bar type DXDiag, it'll tell you. An i7 can be really good, but if you're running something older, like a 960, then it might not cut it. But if you're running something relatively newish, like a 3770 or something even newer, then you shouldn't have a problem with that CPU. Like, this may be just need to get a new GPU. All the Intel performance upgrades over the past 3 to 5 years have been incremental. Okay. Yeah, it's getting a bit older, but those were a very solid unit back in the day. You might want to consider upgrading to a new Skylake, like the... Not even the 6700, but yeah, the 7700, because yeah, the Kaby Lake is really good, like, for gaming, that is. I talked over you. Yeah, because you... Well, you can keep the case and the hard drives, but yeah, that's more or less complete. Because you'll need to go to DDR4. Where did that guy go? I'd recommend the KB Lakes. You can, if you're not planning on overclocking, you can save yourself $100 on your processor. Because I was talking to a guy. Sorry, I talked to myself a bit. So how much, what was your budget like? That should be more than enough. You've got to remember though that you might not get the performance you would like in Star Citizen, even after spending all that money. Oh no! I find the PU for one has a worse performance than the PU. It has worse performance overall in the whole game, like than just. Yeah, I noticed that it shifts as well. Yeah, I think there's a memory leak in the server application. I'm pretty sure it is. So what's happening is that the crewing sort of load and not killing assets properly over time. And you know, you're right, like, it's more people, but you'll probably want to do a rebuild if you've got other games in mind as well, like, you know, coming up, like, I can't think of anything off the top of my head, but it's probably about time to upgrade the 2600, and if you're going to do a rebuild, you may as well just keep the 2600. Know, use it as a media server. Yeah, because I kept my old one and managed to refurb it a little bit, just new motherboard and stuff. And now I've got two computers. Mine are both workstations, so I do a lot of sort of heavy computational stuff. The 5820 is also a really good buy, though. The clock speed is a little bit slower, but it's got 6 cores, so... No, it's an Intel. Yeah, it's a bit of a beast. The other thing to remember nowadays is that your GPU is doing all the heavy lifting. So you can theoretically, I mean, with a budget of $3,000, like, you're fine. You can get a really decent high-end machine. But you really, in gaming, your heavy lifting is done on the GPU. So even if you've got a high-end i5, you should still be, like, okay to dump that money into your GPU. But a 1080 plus a 7700, if you are you thinking of overclocking or just running at stock?
Round over.
Oh, nice.
We've been assigned a different infiltration point. Let's use it to our advantage.
New round.
Darling, you're with me, always around me. Only love, only love. Yeah, just a tad. Well, it'll be the same amount of warm air, won't it? Well, you're not creating additional heat unless you're overclocking it. But yeah, I mean, I only use an all-in-one cooler. I don't have a lot of experience with aftermarket cooling, but I use an all-in-one Corsair unit just because I prefer the build that way, and you do get better temperature. I do find that my room gets really warm. I've got two of them running, so it's pretty excessive, but in summer it's intolerable, so I have to put the aircon on, and you'll find in a smaller room will, even whether you're overclocking or not, you'll find that your room will warm up pretty noticeably if you've got a small space. Sorry, I'm just gaming at the same time. But I don't have a lot of experience with aftermarket cooling. My little brother had one, and one thing I can tell you is it's fucking loud. Like, it is really loud. I could hear, he'd have his computer in the lounge room, and I was sort of two rooms away in my bedroom, and you could hear it, like, it's louder than an aircon, because that's essentially what it is, really. Yeah, really loud. So if you're one of the people who like a quiet machine, and I thought I didn't really care until I until I heard his rig, if you like a quiet machine, then... then yeah, it's something you'll want to consider, especially in a confined space. Yeah, you can get leakage and stuff, which isn't ideal. Gotcha. Yeah. I like the all-in-one. I don't overclock. But the thing with overclocking to consider is, it'll add 100. The K variant will add price, or $100-$120. It's worth. If you're going to do it, you're going to do it. But it's worth considering, especially with the KB Lake. You're only going to get maybe 500-800 megahertz out of your chip extra, because they're at 4.2 on turbo. So you're really looking at 5 max. Is that 800 megahertz like really worth it to you? The other thing is, I don't know a lot about overclocking, to be honest with you. I don't. My chips are too expensive to really justify it, but it will, as far as I know, it will decrease the longevity of the chip. It can only be like a marginal decrease, and a lot of people say, nah, it's fine, I get by okay. But you're putting more voltage and more heat through the chip, so... Yeah, it's good. Well, with $3,000, that's a great budget, man. Like, that'll my rig cost me $3,000.
Control point contested.
Yeah, they're still hefty. They can be really hefty, like a 4K monitor. Really dark shadow on the hill. Yeah, that's a good point. My cold hearted child, tell me where it all contested. I didn't even try that round. I wasn't even paying attention, I was talking to you. I went 26-1.